Right, so what we're going to show here is a user coming in, a new customer coming into our website and clicking buy now. As they fill out their details here and eventually hit place your order, what that is going to trigger is an automated provisioning step to give them access to a new control room, basically our software control room for RPA, deployed on our global cloud. Now that automated provisioning will take about 10 minutes. It could be anywhere in the world, and you can see the example here, we've selected the United States. The way that we do that is with a continuous integration, continuous delivery software stack. So it's all basically baked into the code. And once that system is up and running, the user will receive an email, which you can see here, giving them a custom URL to log into and their credentials. And what we're going to show here is, this is the first time anybody has logged into this system. So administrator within the customer gets their credentials, logs in, and does a couple of security steps just to change their password and set up some security questions so that in the event that they forget their password, they can recover on their own. So they go through these initial steps. There's a click through for the end user license agreement. And at that point, they're in the system. They can actually start building bots. They can start setting up other users, and away they go. All right, so here we're back with the administrator who got initially set up. And what we're going to show is them now looking at how can they add users. So one of the most common pieces here is to tie into an organization's single sign-on environment. In this example, we're using a Google identity provider, and we're linking this control room environment into their single sign-on environment so that their users can get access in a controlled way. Now, having done that, then what we're going to look at is setting up a new department. We're going to set up a finance department, and we're going to do it in a secure manner. So we start by creating a repository for the finance department's bots. This will only be accessible by the finance department and the citizen developers within that department. Now, to help them do this in a secure way, we're going to set up a new role for finance bot creators. So essentially think of this as citizen developers within the finance department. And we're going to give them enough access so that they can create bots and test out their bots themselves, but limit where they can actually run the bots to that development environment. We're not going to give them access to the test environment, to the production environment. They are going to be able to access Bot Store to download example bots from Automation Anywhere. And we're going to limit their ability to check in and check out those bots just to the repository that we just set up for the finance department. So that's essentially the role setup. And now what we're going to do is go and set up a user. So we want to set up a citizen developer within the finance department. His name's Ann Smith. And here we're basically going to set them up with an initial username and password and leverage that finance development role that we just set up. So once we finish this user setup procedure, there'll be an automated email that goes out to that user with her credentials, and then she can log in. And we'll show that in a minute. I just wanted to mention we've also given this user a bot creator license. And so that's Anne created. She'll get an email with her credentials, and now she can log into the system. Finally here, we're going to show another aspect of enabling new departments is there can be certain actions and packages that you want them to be able to access in their bots that you may not want to give to other departments. So we're going to show an example here of just enabling the finance team with access to some G Suite actions that they can then build into their bots as they're creating them. So this gives you additional kind of both security control across the departments and what they can access, which systems they're using. But it's also, G Suite is a fairly standard package in this example. But the other powerful thing here is that as a central administrator, I can set up a custom package that can be tailored to a system that this department has, and maybe in multiple departments have. We've had customers do this, for example, where they wanted to do standardized consent checks on client data across departments. So they can create that custom package and make it very easy for those citizen developers to leverage that and make progress rapidly with enabling the bots. Now we're going to go back and log in again as Bonnie Murphy. So Bonnie Murphy is in the security department for this organization. And when she gets in here, you'll see very limited access into the systems on the left-hand side. But her role is essentially to set up a credential vault for any of the departments. But in this case, she's going to set up a credential vault with username, password, or the ability for citizen developers to use their username and password specifically for the Salesforce application. So here, the security administrator is basically allowing the setup of the username and password, making sure it's masked, and tying that into a locker for Salesforce credentials specifically for the finance department and specifically for Salesforce. So once this is set up, this allows the citizen developer to securely save their login credentials within the credential vault. And obviously, as the security department admin, they want control over who can do this and which systems can get access. So that's that setup, that credential vault setup with lockers. Now, what we're going to show here finally is Anne Smith, the finance bot creator that we showed earlier, logging in. And we're going to show briefly a bot. Actually, we're going to show her actually setting up her credentials. These are specific to her, but she's now got this access into the credential vault to store them securely. And once she's done this, she'll be able to access these easily from the bot creation workbench whenever she has or is building a bot that needs to access her account in Salesforce. So that's the mechanism saved. And here is this example. You can see the credential vault set up for Salesforce, and that is basically telling the bot to go and act via the credential vault, pull out her credentials to log into Salesforce and continue with the bot